The debris is just unbelievable.
That's the part that's crazy. It's just that's all that's left.
You don't find a desk. You don't find a chair. You don't find a telephone. A computer.
That's the part that's crazy. It's just that's all that's left.
Almost cleanly on themselves. Where did they go?
Everything was dust and metal.
The building collapsed to dust.
Early estimates were that it would take up to 2 years to clean up Ground Zero. But in fact, the process went much more quickly and was significantly under budget.
Architects, engineers, people who work with steel, welders have just never seen the level of destruction and the level of deformation of this material in our lives.
I found it hard to believe that it actually bent because of the size of it and how there's no cracks in the iron. It bent without almost a single crack in it.
Just everything is smashed to atoms. There are no big pieces of anything.
There were no desks. There were no phones. There were, maybe now and then you find a fragment of something, but basically everything was just pulverized.
There wasn't a computer screen, a laptop, there was no office. I mean, it was, 210-story buildings of office equipment. It's beyond comprehension.
It was like the surface of another planet. All there was powdered debris and metal. It was a very strange scene.
And just the debris fields, just amazing. It's beyond anything I've ever seen like that. I've seen collapses and demolition buildings, but nothing like this was unbelievable. Like I said, there wasn't a door, there wasn't anything to be found. It was all disintegrated, all rubble. Concrete was small little pieces, not even slabs. No desk, no furniture, no computers, no phones, no anything. So I imagine so the people were the same as the building, nothing left.
Where did all that building material disappear to?
Disappeared into its own dust.
You were walking in dust maybe up to your ankles.
All the furnishings and the fixtures inside the building, none of that existed after the collapse. There were no desks, there were no phones, no computers, no copy machines, no chairs, nothing. That had all been pulverized by the tremendous amount of energy that was created by this collapse. And it was just pulverized into this dust.
Started digging those first couple of buckets, I started to look at this dust, this powder, and all I could think of is that that I was getting this eerie feeling that there was people in this pulverized dust.
Where is everybody?
Yeah, it was. I mean, you didn't find a shard of glass, anything that looked like would be used by a person. You just didn't see. It was just concrete, steel. That was it, and dust. And it was just, you didn't find a shard of glass, anything that...
Engineers at the firm that built the building's best guess to account for the missing 1,200 feet of material from each tower is that large portions simply vaporized into the dust that rained down on New Yorkers immediately after the collapse. It was that powerful. We're talking here about 43,600 windows, 600,000 square feet of glass, 200,000 tons of structural steel, 5 million square feet of gypsum, 6 acres of marble, and 425,000 cubic yards of concrete, turned in good part into a cloud, says environmental medical doctor Stephen Levin.
I was astonished at the degree to which solid materials were turned into pulverized dust as a consequence of that building collapse. I think it was striking.
The Environmental Protection Agency has been sampling the dust, and one specialist told ABC they believe the clouds that appeared immediately after the collapse were mostly gypsum dust from drywall, cement dust, and plaster, which can cause problems.
Cement dust is an irritant. Fine glass powder is also an irritating material.
The EPA did find spotty levels of asbestos. A sample on a police car turned out dangerous. Another sample a couple of blocks away, not dangerous. But most interesting in the mix, they are looking, they think, at specks of steel that used to be beams and elevators. Marble from the lobby floor and facings. So what were once the strongest architectural elements in the two towers were pulverized, large portions turned into clouds like this one.
They're both down now. This is a huge cloud of smoke.
People who have been right down next to the base of what was the trade towers say there's virtually nothing left, maybe a few flights of stairs, a few stories of one of the buildings, but that when they came down, there was so much melting and so much demolishing of any kind of structure that they cannot.
It's an interesting question when you saw those two giant towers collapse almost cleanly on themselves. Where did they go? I have read in some architecture article that they were made mostly of air. If you consider the space between the solid molecules, the steel, the concrete, the glass, the aluminum, there was a lot of air, was mostly air actually. Where did they go was part of the disbelief that I was feeling.
All that's standing of the Twin Towers right now in the background. That's all that's standing. That's it. That's all that's left.
So you're literally right inside. What time did you actually photograph?
I don't even know. That was actually, I rode my motorcycle right up from there. That was like about, that was about an hour ago, not even.
And this is right at the center of where the trade towers stood.
You can see, like, when you see the firemen, they just, there's nothing they can do. It's just, like, amazing.
It's absolutely...
Look at that. That's all that's left.
Do you know whether that's the south tower or the north tower?
That's the south tower.
And you saw no sign of life in here whatsoever.
See, that's the concourse below. That's going down like 20 feet or so. But that's the part that's crazy. It's just that's all that's left.
On the surface, firefighters and others continued to comb the debris for remains. Aside from huge pieces of twisted steel from the towers, there was little that was recognizable in the debris. Shrapnel-like fragments, gray dust. No one had ever seen anything like it, even at the site of the Murrah building in Oklahoma City, also destroyed by an act of terrorism.
They said, you know, in Oklahoma City, you could see pieces of desks and chairs, and it was something that told you that this was an office building. At the World Trade Center site, it seems like everything was pulverized.
One of the more unusual artifacts to emerge from the rubble is this rock-like object that has come to be known as the meteorite.
This fused element of steel, molten steel and concrete and all of these things all fused by the heat into one single element.
And almost like a chunk of lava from Kilauea or Iceland, where they're very sharp but breakable shards on the end here.
By September 12th, the Fresh Kills landfill had been chosen as the site where small debris would be sorted. Fresh Kills, an enormous waste facility on Staten Island, sits across the New York Harbor from Ground Zero. New York City Police Deputy Inspector Jim Luongo and FBI agent Richard Marks have been in charge of the operation from the beginning. They've also led the effort to save personal property and artifacts for museums, hoping to keep these memories alive with future generations.
Is there one artifact that stands out for any particular reason for you?
I think the lack of artifacts stands out to me quite a bit. I think the fact that I haven't seen a door, I haven't seen a phone, I haven't seen a computer, I haven't seen a doorknob, I think that stands out. But for the things that we have seen, every now and then we'll come across a stuffed animal that might have been on somebody's desk. Pictures that were on people's desks that we're trying to restore.
Perhaps the most astonishing object Shate found is something there should have been thousands of. This one probably only survived because it was in the basement. It belonged to an ice cream store.
I'd pretty much given up trying to find some sort of intact file cabinet. But while I was at the compound for the Port Authority Police, this ball of metal about the size of a basketball was delivered to them. You can see what remains of the file folders that were inside.
In the beginning, there were people that wanted the name of the landfill changed. They thought it was a morbid thing. But a kill is Dutch for a river. And so the name was kept. First, when I saw it, I thought they were moving mounds of dirt around with loaders. And what we were seeing was the ground remains of the World Trade Center. And it had a very organized sense to it. The material came in these buckets all together and put in one place. And then it was sorted. We saw nothing we could recognize in the fields. We expected to see chairs and file cabinets and what was left of offices. Everything was reduced to the finest state. It basically looked like mountains of dirt. There were hills of gray dirt, vast expanses of wire, twisted rebar, fields of steel, and the fields of vehicles. The minute we got there and wouldn't let us take our pictures, we planned to figure out a way to get back there and take photographs.
First of all, let's go back to your basic premise that there was a pool of molten steel. I know of absolutely nobody, and no eyewitness who said so.
You'd get down below and you'd see molten steel, steel running down the channel rails. Like you're in a foundry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like lava.
Like lava from a volcano.
The fires got very intense down there, and it actually melted
beams where it was molten steel that was being dug out.